Hey guys, I've got two recycle projects for you today. And so you are gonna need some random supplies that hopefully you have in your recycle bin because hopefully you recycle, or you might have around the house that you'll be able to save to be able to do this in the future when you're done with these items. So item number one is we're gonna make a necklace out of marker caps. I have about a bajillion of these in my classroom and at my studio. And so I'm always thinking, what could I do with these? So I've got an idea for you. And then I have a coffee lid because I like coffee. I did not used to like coffee. I only love the smell of it. And then, you know, you run a business and you work full time and you've got to have something to get you going in the morning. So coffee it is. But if you don't have any, like a plastic lid, this could be, you know, sour cream lid, butter lid. Like just think about lids that you might have in your fridge. But if you don't have a lid, cardboard. Cardboard would actually work great, okay? It's just a little harder to cut through, right? And I know there's different thicknesses of cardboard, so whatever works. But I am gonna start with this project and then I'll move on to the necklace project while this dries. So we're gonna turn this into a spinner that we'll put a coin in. I have a quarter. We'll insert a coin and turn it into like a top, like a spinner. You could use Sharpie for this. I think Sharpie would be fabulous, way less messy. I know there's a lot of families out there that, you know, sometimes it's hard to be messy at home. I get it. I go in freak out mode after I've cleaned and then my house gets messy. But if you're all about having a little mess and keeping the kids entertained for a while, they could use paint on this. They could even, let's see, Sharpie paint. They could even like, you know, glue on little pieces of scrap construction paper, you know, cut out shapes and designs and glue those on. But this has a little lip on it, right? And I want to get rid of that. So I'm going to use some scissors. Parents, I highly suggest that you do this because it's not that hard. It's just a little bit tricky. And if you're not careful, you could cut yourself, which means that your kids could definitely cut themselves if they're not careful. So I'm cutting right inside where the lip is, and it makes like a perfect circle, right? So I'm just following that perfect circle instead of trying to make a perfect circle, which is super tricky, right? Okay, so now I have a circle.
If you're doing cardboard or something like that that's thicker and it's obviously probably not a circle, find something round around your house, like a cup, and use the rim of the cup, trace it with a pencil, and then cut it out. Then you don't have to worry about making a perfect circle. Now, I do want to kind of figure out where the middle is. So I'm going to fold in half again. So it's like I've made fourths. And I'm gonna put me just a little snip right there. And I know that that is the very center. Now I don't want my snip to be too big or my quarter will fall right out. So I would just do little bits at a time, kind of measure. Obviously it needs to be bigger. And we still want our slit to be in the center. So maybe I should cut it while it's folded. Okay, there. So now my quarter is in. I think I need to do a little slit this way, just a smidge. Just a smidge. There we go. Okay. Perfect. Okay. And that way it fits right there in the center. Okay. But I'm going to pull this out, save it for later, and recycle this leftover piece or use it for a future project. Now, I am going to divide mine into, let's see, I'm going to divide it in half, and I'm just using a Sharpie. And then I'm going to do, I'm going to try to divide the half into thirds. So 1/3, 2/3, and then there's 3/3. So this is a great opportunity to talk about fractions and with your kiddos, and how fractions put together can make halves or wholes or whatever it may be. Okay, so now I'm going to use, like I said, Sharpie would be so good for this project. And I could just draw a bunch of lines on this and call it good. Or make some little designs like Zentangles, little, you know, shapes, lines, designs on here, call it good. But, you know, I'm going to take it a step further. So I'm going to do almost like a color wheel. So red. Clean my brush. In order to clean my brush, I smush and swirl on the bottom of the cup. Smush and swirl. Wipe, 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 wipe. And then dry, dry, dry. If you don't dry your brush, it's going to drip everywhere. Now, I don't have orange. So, get my little mixing plate over here. And I'll take a little bit of yellow. And a tiny bit of red. And mix, 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 mix. And now I have an orange. Now, if your lid is dark, you could add white paint to all of your colors, and that's going to make your colors not so see-through, and they'll really pop against the dark lid. So red, orange. Next in my color wheel is going to be yellow. And I want it to pop a little bit, so I'm going to mix some white in there. There we go. Start at the center, pull my brush to the edge. I don't want to put my paint on super duper thick or it'll take forever to dry. Now, I don't have green, so I'm going to take some yellow. Mix in just a little bit of blue. You didn't know you were getting a color lesson today, did you? You just thought you were making recycled art. I love doing recycled art. Anytime I can do something to help the environment, I really try to. I even carpool to work thanks to my awesome PE teacher at school and my awesome librarian at school. Reuse bags, take my own bags to the store, you know, take shorter showers, don't leave the water running while you're brushing your teeth, turn off the lights when you leave a room, reuse materials anytime that you can, hand-me-down clothes and books and toys. So all of those things that I can do to help the environment, I really try to. Okay, clean, dry, and blue, and then after the blue will be the purple. So I start at the center, pull my brush to the edge. Now, tempera paint is not really going to work on this project if you're using plastic, nor will watercolors. They'll just rub right off, okay? So that's why I'm using acrylic paint, so that it will grab a hold on the plastic and dry onto it. Otherwise, tempera just flakes right off. It's kind of weird and crazy. Okay, and then purple. There we go. Just like that. Ta-da! Oh, that is beautiful! Now we have this awesome color wheel. Okay, so we'll set this aside and just let that dry a little bit. You could even decorate the other side, and then when they're tired of looking at one side, they just turn the whole thing over, and then they have the other side to look at, right? So it'd be dual purpose, dual designs. But I'm going to set this out of the way to dry for a minute. Wipe my fingers. The paint will wash off your hands, no worries. And now
I've got just some curling ribbon. If you don't have curling ribbon, string would work, yarn would work. Yarn might be a little tricky. You may have to tape the end to keep it from coming unraveled. Regular ribbon, just whatever you have, okay? I'm gonna cut it long enough so that if I were to tie a knot, it's gonna fit over my head, right? Okay. So that way I can get it on and off. So, I don't want to tie a knot yet. I don't have anything on it. What am I thinking? Okay. So what I'm going to do is, you could put these in some sort of order. This would be a great time to talk about red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. It's a great time to talk about rainbow order, you know, Roy G. Biv. It's a great time to make a pattern. You could do like an AB pattern, ABC pattern. So this is a great opportunity to pull in some different learning concepts if you can, okay? Let's see, red, I don't have another orange, yellow, green, don't have another blue, purple, pink, black, red, black. So I'm just using what I have, guys, and that's what we do here at the house. So obviously I have a ton more of this at my studio and at Artsy or at school. Now I am starting on the end that's the very top of the cap. And if you look in there, I don't know if you've ever looked in there before, but there are holes. And I just got this in there a second ago. There we go. So I am gonna string that through the hole. Now, if we're not careful, this end down here, they'll just lose their cap right through to the other end. So you might help them hold on to their cap. Now, this is great for hand-eye coordination. The little bitties are probably not gonna be able to do this, but the little bit older ones will be able to. So I would say 5 and older should be able to do this. But this is great for hand-eye coordination because it's getting them to make the string, and this curling ribbon is working great. So if you have that, they might be more successful. Because it's real thin, right? And it's just wide enough to fit in these holes that are in the cap. But this is going to teach them hand-eye coordination, making their string that's in their dominant hand go where their eyes are seeing it to go. And so anytime you can work on that fine motor skill, OMG, it's going to help them with a lot of other things. So, this could even be fun just to keep them busy. If you don't even turn it into a necklace, just have them thread it on there. And you could turn it into a competition. Well, I don't know, maybe not. But a competition between your kids and see who can string X amount of caps on the ribbon the fastest. But, just an idea. And so we just keep working these on here until you get as many on there as you want to. You could even do a pattern like a cat, like if you have some big wooden beads. Oh, how fun would that be? Like, or big plastic beads. But like do a couple beads and then a lid and then a couple beads and then a lid. And this one is not wanting to go through. Oh, there we go. And I actually cut the end of my ribbon to an angle so that it would be kind of pointy at one end and be able to go in the hole a little easier. Once we get close to the end, it's going to be tricky to get these on. So you might think about that. There. So, this could even be a fun little project, you know? Mommy gets a little quiet time while they are stringing the caps on.
And then when they're done stringing the caps on, they've earned something. You know, it could be like, you gotta work first and then you can earn some time doing something you want to do. I'm nearing the end and I don't want to lose my caps on the end, but I need, there we go. So I've got it resting. One end is resting in my lap, but your kiddos just have to remember if they lift it up too high, they could just all fall off the end, right? Okay, I think I can fit one more on here comfortably to give myself enough room to be able to tie. So I just pull it out a little, push it in, pull it out, push it in until it finally pushes through the holes. So like I said, they're real, real skinny holes that are on there. Okay, and then I'll take the two ribbons together and I am going to wrap them around my finger if they'll fit. Didn't leave myself much room, did I? Okay. And then I'm tucking both ends, maybe, there we go, through the loop that I just made. And there. Okay. And now I have this really fun marker lid necklace. Excellent use for all of those extra lids that you might have laying around the house. And we actually did a project where you can use all your old markers. So say this is a marker that doesn't work anymore. I just pop the cap off, keep the cap for a future project like this. Take the marker, put it in a little jar of water with just a little bit of water at the bottom. All the ink drains out, and now you've made a liquid watercolor paint. So that is a video that's already posted that you can go back and watch. But excellent use for getting that last bit of ink out of your markers before you recycle. And then you can actually ship these back to Crayola and they will recycle them for you. So pretty cool. Now, let's get back to our cap. It is not quite dry, so you could, if your kids are getting impatient, you could have them waving it, you could get a blow dryer out and blow dry it, or, you know, distract them with something else for a little bit while this finishes drying, and then they can go back to it and have their fun. But I am gonna just go ahead, even though it's not dry, pop the quarter in. Come on. Okay, pop the quarter in. It's about halfway, maybe a little less than halfway. Their fingers are gonna have an easier time. I need to go get my nails done. They're way too long. But when they spin it, it's pretty cool. And it takes a lot of practice making that hand do what they want to, but it looks really pretty from the top spinning. They could even do two primary colors. So when it mixes, it looks like the secondary. So like I could have done it half yellow, half red. And then whenever it was spinning, it would look like it was orange, right? Because yellow and red, when it mixes, makes orange. So this is a great color theory project for them. They could mix yellow and they could do half yellow, half blue. So when they spin it, it's green, or half red, half blue. So when they spin it, it's purple. So that could be a great color theory project for them as well, and kind of explains how that works when colors mix. One more thing I want to show you real quick before we call it quits. One more color thing about this is when we mix yellow and purple, you actually are going to get brown. You're going to get, because when you mix two complements, you get a brown. So colors that are across from each other on the color wheel are called complementary colors. So yellow and purple are complements. When mixed, they can darken each other. When mixed with equal amounts, makes brown. Orange and blue are complementary colors, and you can use blue to darken orange to darken blue, or when mixed, makes brown. And then same thing, red and green are complementary colors. And when we mix red,
when we mix red with green, we can make brown. A little bit of green with red darkens the red. A little bit of red into green darkens the green. So there's some fun color thoughts for you today. And two awesome recycle projects. I hope that you enjoyed getting into my brain with me today. Make sure and check out all those links below to see what supplies I used and to see other projects that I have going on. And give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, share the post, like the post, all that good social media stuff. So thanks guys for hanging out with me, and I cannot wait to do some more art with you.